Today, I'm still in the hotel room right now that we stayed in for the past week in London, and it has been wonderful. I'm really gonna miss it a lot. However, this morning we are going actually right downstairs to get on a bus for a week, and the name of the tour is England and Scotland Heritage, and what is it? Scottish Tours. And we are going to, there are going to be stops in England, and then we're going to go up into Scotland. For example, we're going to go to Windsor Castle, we're going to go to Bath and places like that, but then we are going to go up into Scotland and then come back down. So I didn't want to talk in front of all those people downstairs, so that's why I'm explaining to you right now. When you see filming on a bus or things like that, then that is what we're doing. We are on this tour, and so what's convenient about it is we are at this Premier Inn, Waterloo, and it is, you meet the bus literally right downstairs and next door. Kevin did not do that on purpose. That just happened to be where you meet this tour group. And when they bring us back, they will be bringing us back at the same place. And we are actually, we're not staying at this Premier Inn. There's one right across the way, and we're going to stay at that Premier Inn just for one night until we go back home. So we don't even want to think about that yet. But so for these next few videos, and for the rest of this video and for the next few videos, you're going to be seeing Windsor Castle and Bath and places like that, and you're getting to see them because we're on this bus tour. Kevin, since this was our first time here, Kevin was not comfortable renting a car. A lot of people would have just rented a car. He didn't want to do that. Maybe next time we're over here, he'll be more comfortable in doing that. But for this first time, we've never been on a bus tour, so we figured we would see what it was like and see if we really liked it or not. So we will be able to let you know the ins and outs of this tour when we're finished, because we feel like there were a lot of unanswered questions about where you stop and where you're gonna get lunch and things like that, because we like to plan. And so we feel like hopefully we're gonna be able to help you decide whether this is a tour you would like. So just stay tuned.
Thank you for your patience. Again, I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Bridget. I am your travel director. Also, we have Urich, pronouncing it right, Urich, who's going to be our driver for the first 2 days of our trip. The very first thing I'd also like to do is welcome you all to your Cost Saver Trafalgar tour. Hopefully you'll absolutely enjoy the next 8 days. We have a lot in store for you. And just before I go into anything else, the very first thing we also do is play our safety DVD. And then I shall tell you a bit more about the trip and our plan for the day.
On behalf of everyone in Trafalgar and Brendan, we'd like to thank you for having chosen to travel with us.
Your safety and comfort is of paramount importance to Trafalgar. So before we start this adventure together, please watch this video carefully.
Firstly, to start off with, I do know many of you have travelled a very long way to join us here in London. So I'm keeping in mind as much as possible that some of you may be still a bit jet lagged from your arrival. But today we do have a lot of the initial just paperwork and forms and things to get through. I'll try to make it for you as painless and easy as possible. Let me tell you all about what we're going to get up to on our first day. Actually, before I tell you that though, I'll just go through those last main points about our coach and the safety side. On our particular coach, you may notice it is a brand spanking new coach. Stop, and then we wait 5 minutes in each city for people, 5 minutes here, 5 minutes there. It does add up for you at the end of the day, taking off from the different cities, and it's that little bit shorter in each place. And considering, you know, there is 47 of us, If everyone can be time conscious, things like, you know, if you know that we're departing at a set time, to make sure that you've done everything you need to do, bath.
Windsor traffic.
So we have these boxes and you have an earpiece, and that way when we get to wherever we're going, we can hear her when she has announcements to make through this box.
Thank you.
So this is the city of Windsor, and so you saw that we just got off the bus, and this is called the, what's it called, the Wonky House? The Wonky House.
Literally built it.
And then this is like the shortest street in Britain right here. This one right here. This is it. And do you want to buy it? Yeah, the Wonky House is for sale, and this is called the Carpenter's Arms. There's a bar back here. There's a bakery. Sure. Well, I wanted to see something real quick. This is the back of the Wonky House. And so Kevin will have a picture. The Three Tons, is that what that's called? That's a bar. Thank you.
Okay, we are entering a park right now, Park Street Gate, and wow.
It was a long walk. There's no such thing as a dog park. That's pretty fun.
Ashley would like this for to do her. Yeah, Ashley would absolutely love that to do her runs. Yeah, if we lived here, you could come here and go down and back and be done. Some people are still walking in the grass, too.
Yeah, I wonder if there's a way you can get into the actual park.
Look at the horses. You see the horses up through there?
That's the castle.
I could take pictures of these planes flying all day long because it's constant. We are literally just walking around exploring. These are people's gardens. They share these gardens, which is completely foreign to us. But like, you have your own piece of land and that you, I think, rent, and you can plant what you want. And this might be one family, that's another family, that's another family. And you come here and you take care of it.
So we've come on down further into like the town part. And there is a hotel right here. And that you don't see, there's no like shops down here like there are up at the front. But there's some very interesting looking houses, very pretty. And the wisteria, I wouldn't have thought that this was a place where wisteria would grow because of the cold. And the wisteria is so healthy and it just hangs from everything. There's the park again. Okay, so this is a beautiful row of houses. I have no idea where we are, so I can't really tell you, but all I can tell you is that they're beautiful. And it looks like they're four stories. You have three at the top, and then you have a basement. I like these up here behind this wall because they have a different glass. Those have like a regular glass, and these, they're not stained, but they're just really pretty. Yeah. And they have different color, a different color brick. They have the designs in the brick. This is called Bachelor's Acre, and it is, we're still in Windsor. It says Golden Jubilee Ox Roast. That's what this is from. There was probably something at the top of that. But this looks like a park for kids. Look, this is a cute monument. I'll get up close to it and show it to you. So Kevin's taking a picture of this, but that's actually the queen with her corgis. That is so cute. If any of you have corgis, you'll appreciate this. I think corgis are adorable. I think I like them because they have little round barrel bodies like Guido. Guido has the pugs have that barrel body. What does it say?
Diamond Jubilee in 2012.
That's a very nice monument.
The Windsor Lady.
The Windsor Lady. Very nice. And then this park has, there goes another airplane. This park has a play yard for kids. And then these fountains. That looks like about it. It looks like you just you walk around and or sit. It's really nice though. It's right in the middle of town.
I didn't see that.
Oh, look.
The castle, because that's what they do at Buckingham Palace.
Yeah.
You're gonna get a hat.
Is that where we need to be? So we're crossing the street. We're still in Windsor, of course. I guess I'll tell you when we change towns. I will let you know. But we really didn't walk around by the castle much at all, because you have to pay to get in there, and it's 20 pounds per person. So we've just really been enjoying sightseeing in the town, and see the crowd. The crowd is up here to see these soldiers. So this would not have been a good place to wait. Yeah, I'm glad we were where we were at. There is a TK Maxx. Yeah, that would not have been a good place to stand, just so you all know, in front of that statue. So if you come, please keep going down to the end of the street. Do you remember the name of that, whatever that street was?
Sheet Street.
That's, yeah, that's where they come out of, is Sheet Street. And that's really where you need to be. Okay, this is the coach, the bus that we're on. It says Simply the Best Trafalgar, and it's brand new. She said that it was a brand new bus. And so I'll just show you around the outside. I think she said there's like 47 people in our group. Did she say there's 47 people in our group?
Trout, crushed potatoes in lemon dressing. Option 3 is a mushroom risotto with parmesan sprinkled on top. Then your 3 choices for dessert. Sticky toffee pudding with toffee sauce. Yeah, this is, if you're wanting to try the distinctly British option, sticky toffee pudding you can find everywhere, but it is the one.
If you also choose to go in, you can get an audio guide, an audio headset, and what you can choose to do is there's about 5 different people who, 5 different voices you can choose to narrate you through the Roman baths and the museum. One is just the strict fix, and I'll be, again, point out some things when we get there, but 3 churches or 3 places of worship have stood here through time. So the first one from Saxon time, the second one from the Normans, when the Normans came through and conquered. From about 1090 they put in they built their own cathedral, bigger than the one that is there now, absolutely beautiful, but they couldn't sustain this particular structure by those series of Downton Abbey, with a house in London and a house in the country. And these houses just were a display of wealth and power that they had. They would be absolutely ornate, and especially in the Georgian period, with the architecture that we see here, the Georgian... So yeah, so largely rebuilt from the time of World War II, and we will see that as we go into town. So as we're going in now, starting to see more of the Georgian style architecture. I'll point out more once we get a bit closer. But you'll want to have the cameras out and ready for when we go around the circle, and then along the crescent. We're going to drive along slowly to get you some beautiful photos as well. But we can start to see all the chimneys along the tops of the roofs. What you can see on a few buildings, I can't see them right now, but on a few of the buildings, they've got some windows blocked up. You can see, obviously, there used to be windows there, but they've blocked them up with bricks. And that's because at one stage in the history, they in the more recent history, in the last couple of hundred years, they started to charge people for how many windows they had on their facade. And so those that didn't quite have the funds, they just covered up their windows, bricked them up in the rooms that were less important. Younger, who is the architect of this particular circle that we can see, He was inspired by the Colosseum, which is no surprise. Perfect, beautiful circle all the way around. Nicolas Cage once had a house around here as well. Not anymore, but he also once lived in Bath. So if anyone wants to get some of the photos, go for it. The street lights that we see around the arch too were not the original ones, but when they did filming here, the filming company left them here as a gift to the city so that it was all in the same era. Looks like there's a bit of work going on up there, but out to our right hand side. Sorry, I know it's tough to get your picture between the trees. But if you want to walk there as well, from when, it's not too far. It's about a 15-minute walk from where we stop. Now, when this was built, it was designed and built, and then people could buy as much of the facade, essentially, as they wanted, and then they would just do what they would like to build it out. So. What may look like one house, what may look like two houses, someone would have bought is for the whole one property.
You see the horse. Well, they had a horse racing here. Thank you. This is a Bath Abbey, and we paid £2.50 each to get in. They say you don't have to, but you do. It's not a donation. That's how much it costs. But I tell you what, it's worth £2.50 to get in here. It is absolutely stunning. See the angels? Angels up here, and here's another window. Everywhere you look, there's stained glass. It's absolutely amazing. Okay, today we're going to be having lunch at the stable. It's pizza, pies, and cider. It's Bath's Finest Pizza, Pies, and Cider. We are in Bath. Okay, we're going in Poundland for the first time. Thank you.
pretty gorgeous.
It's beautiful. No, I'm coming across here so I can... I just wanted to be able to... That's Bath Abbey. That's where we were just a little while ago. We did not go in the Roman Bath, like I said. It was just too expensive. But I'm thrilled that we were able to go in the Abbey. Marks and Spencer, right there. M&S, no. This is the Fudge Factory. Speedboat like that.
I wonder if we can go out.
Okay, this is we're at Marks and Spencer, and yeah, somebody told us they had really nice underwear for women. Knickers, yeah, knickers for women.
The lacy.
Yeah, yeah, with the frillies, yeah. Okay, we've never been in one of these, so let's go. We're going in the Iceland. I'm pretty sure Jennifer, this is where she sent me that picture from last night.
Oh, really?
I think it was from an Iceland. No. Okay, well. Yeah, we've already looked. Well, at least we looked. Okay, so Jennifer, if you are watching this video, you see, we went in there and they did not have the ice cream. No. The only time we've seen that one kind was yesterday, and it was in the middle of town. I mean, it was like way far away from our hotel, and there's an Apple store. There would have been no way for us to get back before it melted. They have a Debenhams. That's where Jennifer and Luke and Nathan work.
Oh, really?
Yes, and Whitney. Yeah. Maybe we'll go by and wave. Wave in their honor. Okay, Jennifer, Nathan, and Luke, Debenhams. Hello, Debenhams. We love you.
They may hate it.
If they do, they can't say that because they work there. But no, I think they like working there. And Luke works in the back. Luke.
So he doesn't have to put up with people.
No, he doesn't have to put up with anybody. Oh, look at the little tents. Those are so cute. That's like a cowboy's cowboy theme. And then I love the little girls. That's so feminine. It reminds me of a Laura Ashley. Look at that. Oh, wow. My that's goodness.
Cool. The trail itself.
That's amazing. I love that.
Side, by the way, as some of you said, you didn't get to see it. Up on the left, Putney Bridge, with the shops going across it.
Yeah.
Not to zoom in, are you?
Here we go. Reiner tool, see? Hey folks, just for an update on our ETA, with the traffic we've got, our projected ETA is at approximately an hour from now, just so you know. Traffic coming in and out of Bath and into where we are is just obviously added on that time, just so you know what to expect. With us, and Yurik thought I was joking when we went past our hotel. It's a very narrow driveway, so we're going to just take it from a different angle. It's just a minute back up the road. Apologies for the delay, but we will be there very, very shortly.
Yeah.
Bye.